Philippine President Marcos Jr. bears his administration's 12 candidates for the 2025 midterm polls. The Senate slate is a broad coalition of former and incumbent lawmakers, including the president's sister, Aimee Marcos. Pia Gutierrez has tonight's top story.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. formally introduced on Thursday the administration's senatorial candidates for the 2025 midterm elections. Less than a week before the Commission on Elections opens the period for the filing of certificates of candidacy for next year's polls. The Philippine leader revealed the names comprising the official slate during the convention of the newly established Bagong Pilipinas Coalition at the PICC in Pasay City. This include the president's own sister, re-electionist Senator Aimee Marcos, who was notably absent during the event. Also included in the lineup, former Senator Manny Pacquiao and former Senator Panfilo Lacson, who both ran against Marcos Jr. for the presidency during the 2022 national elections, as well as former Senate President Tito Soto, who meanwhile ran for vice president. Other senatorial candidates of the coalition include other re-electionists, Senators Lito Lapid, Bong Revilla, Pia Cayetano, and Francis Tolentino. Rounding the list are first-timers to the senatorial race: Makati City Mayor Abby Binay, Las Piñas Representative Camille Villor, ACCIS Party List Representative Erwin Tulfo, and DILG Secretary Benhur Abalos.
Mga kababayan, sila po ang lineup ng alyansa. Sa kanilang kalidad at karanasan, mataas ang aking kumpiyansa na sila ay ating magiging katuwang sa ating pagsulong at sa patuloy na pag-unlad ng ating bansa. Atin po sila ay samahan at suportahan. Mabuhay po kayo, mabuhay ang ating lineup, mabuhay ang Bagong Pilipinas.
Another Tulfo is also running for senator as an independent candidate. Ben Tulfo said he decided to run due to public clamor. He was ranked second in a recent poll on preferred senatorial candidates. If both Ben and Erwin are victorious, there will be three Tulfos in the Senate as they join incumbent Senator Rafi Tulfo. All of the senatorial admin bets come from various political parties comprising the administration coalition. Marcos Jr.'s own Partido Federal ng Pilipinas, as well as the Nationalista Party, National Unity Party, Lakas CMD, and the Nationalist People's Coalition. In choosing their candidates, campaign manager Navotas Representative Toby Chanco says they considered support for the president's legislative agenda.
Huwag muna yung winability. Ang importante kasi dito is yung susuporta sa ating legislative agenda, di ba? Kasi kung winnable naman, tapos iba naman yung paniwala nila sa mga batas na dapat isuporta sa presidente, syempre hindi naman natin pwedeng kunin just for convenience.
Senator Tito Soto meanwhile says he is confident of the chances of their senatorial lineup in the 2025 polls.
May local governments, may national, mayroong business, mayroong... It's a very good mix. And I'm glad the NPC group is involved.
Makati City Mayor Abby Binay meanwhile sees no issue campaigning alongside Senator Pia Cayetano, despite the territorial dispute between Makati and Cayetano's bailiwick Taguig over the jurisdiction of Embo Barangays.
I agree to join the alliance because of the president. Sino naman ako para magsabi kung sino yung gusto kong makasama at hindi makasama? Diba? So, I am here to support the projects and programs of the president.
DALG Secretary Benhur Abalos meanwhile says he is ready to resign once he files his candidacy for senator next week. While he did not give details, he confirms the president is already studying some names to be the next DALG chief.